Hi guys, you're watching JT Jones. Don't forget to click on the red subscribe button, and by the way, click on the bell icon so that you receive daily notifications.
What's happening guys, Jones here back with another video, and in this video let's take a look at one of the most unique app that I have ever come across personally. This app promises to replace 36 other apps in your Android device. So without any further delays, let's get started with the video. The app icon looks like this, and as usual all the links are down in the description box below. So let's see how much downloads it has. It has over 1 million downloads and has a rating of 4.6, which is pretty high. Let's open the app itself. Once you open the app, you can see that it is divided into three categories. The first category is productivity and utility tools. The second category is calculation and conversion tools. And the third category is navigation and measuring tools. Let's go by each of these tools one by one. So let's get started. The first thing that we have is Notepad. Secondly, we have Translator. Thirdly, we have Dictionary, Exercise, File Manager, Cutter, Metronome, Recorder, Flashlight, Mirror, Magnifier, Code Scanner, Cleaner, Battery Saver, Stopwatch, Checklist. As you can see, it replaces more than 13 to 14 apps within one of this category, which is pretty amazing. Let's open Notepad and see how it is. This looking simple, clean, and you can take in any of your notes and then save it. Please let you are not filtered into your... This autocorrect can be sometimes very funny guys. So it has a good translator also. For example, if I translate hi in English, it's translating it to Afrikaans, which is same hi. So it also has a good translator. Then we have dictionary, for example, let me find a meaning of something. Let me find a meaning of smart. Okay, so it's giving the meaning of smart, which is amazing. We have a good dictionary also built in. Then we have exercise, which will allow us to take exercise preparation rounds, total time left, etc., etc. Do you really want to exit? Yes, I do. Then we have file manager. So it will show me that I have internal storage of this much, my full storage is this much, etc., etc. So this is also nice. Then we have cutter. I can cut songs easily using this audio video cutter, which is nice. Then we have metronome. I have no idea what a metronome is, but I don't know what a metronome is really. I have no idea what a metronome is. Then we have recorder. Recorder is for recording your audio. Then we have flashlight. Let's give it permission and that's it. It will enable or disable flashlight. Then we have mirror. Mirror means it's self-explanatory guys. Then we have magnifier. So you can magnify things using this app. So it's also nice. Then we have code scanner. Code scanner is for scanning the barcodes. If you have any of the barcodes, you can scan it. Let me see if I have any of the barcode over here. I think it's a QR scanner. It's not a barcode scanner, but anyway, let us scan something and take a look at that. Okay, it has scanned. It says novelty design mini notebook. Okay, that's amazing. So it also works fine. Then we have cleaner. If you want to free up some space in your Android phone, you can use this app. One touch clean is also there. Okay, let me clean it. That's it. I have now more than 90% storage left, which is pretty amazing. Then I have battery saver, stopwatch, checklist is pretty self-explanatory. Then let's go to the second category, which is calculation and conversion tools. Firstly, we have abacus. I don't remember me learning abacus, but if you are someone who has learned abacus, I think you will enjoy this app. It is abacus in itself. Then we have calculator, which is self-explanatory, and it looks as if it's a scientific calculator, which is nice. Then we have currency converter, which is also nice. Then we have unit converter, which is also nice. Then let's go to the third category. The third category is altimeter, compass, heart rate monitor, internet, magnetic monitor, map, pedometer, leveler, time zones, lux meter. Lux meter, I will show you what a lux meter is in a moment. Protractor, ruler, sound meter, tuner. You can also tune your guitar using this app. So as you can see, it does tons of things in a single app. That's why this name is SmartKit 360. It almost does everything. Then we have speedometer, and then we also have vibrometer. Let's see what our altimeter does. So it needs location permissions for calculating the altitude at which you are currently in. Then we have compass, which works as mentioned. Then we have heart rate monitor. Let me calculate my heart rate monitor. 79 beats per minute. I don't know if it is accurate or not, but then it just works. So 94 beats per minute. I think I am excited while making this video. Then we have internet. Okay, this is for analyzing the internet speed. Let us see my slow internet speed. 0.4 Mbps, guys. I don't know how I am surviving with this internet speed, but then my speed is really 0.4 Mbps. Then we have magnetic sensor. Okay. Do I have any metallic object near me? No. I do not have any metallic object near me. Sorry, guys. I would not be able to show you this. Then we have maps, which is also nice, self-explanatory. But who will use this map when you already have Google Maps in your Android device? Then we have pedometer, leveler. Leveler is what? Okay. It's also nice. Then we have time zones, lux meter. Lux meter calculates how much light it is coming through your sensor. It will use this sensor and will calculate how much light it is entering through this sensor. If I close my hands, you will see that it will decrease, and if I take away my hand, it will increase. So this is also nice. Then we have protractor, ruler. Ruler is also self-explanatory. Then we have time zones, sound meter, tuner. Let me see tuner. If you have a guitar, you can tune your guitar also using this app, which is pretty amazing. Then we have speedometer. Okay, I'm sitting down while making this video, so the speed is 0.0 kilometer per hour and 0.0 minutes per second. Then we also have vibrometer. It will calculate if my hands are vibrating or not. As you can see, now the graph is changing, but if I keep it still, the graph will be still. If I vibrate again, it will vibrate. So guys, this app has 36 apps built into it, and I hope you like this video. If you like this video, you know what to do. Do give it a thumbs up. And by the way, if you like this app or the 36 in one app, do give it a thumbs up and go to their Google Play page and do give them a good rating, because they have made this gem of an app which can easily replace most of the apps in your Android device. So I hope you like this video. So that's it for this video, guys. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, do vote it down. Subscribe to my channel for more awesome tech videos. Till then, Jones, and I am signing off.